modeling the enterprise's IT infrastructure, configuration management, inventory and asset management provides an accounting of the entities which comprise the enterprise infrastructure, interacts with each entity through its own life cycle. Configuration management encompasses both inventory and asset management. In addition, it includes establishing and maintaining the relationship between entities, provide a holistic view of the IT infrastructure, support or other IT service management processes. Knowing how individual entities relate to each other, we can then determine if the failure or degradation of one entity will affect other in the IT infrastructure. This knowledge becomes the basis for impact analysis. Object model's goal. This intent to derive an IT infrastructure model stems from the pursuit of better management of IT service. Therefore, the model should aim to accommodate the following provides related goal: better management and accounting of IT assets, better alignment of IT and the business so that they work in partnership to achieve the enterprise objective. Impact analysis of the IT environment for troubleshooting and planning. Object modeling. To understand the IT infrastructure as a collection of related entities, we begin by constructing an object model of the enterprise. Beginning with traditional view of the IT infrastructure as a group of technologies, the model should be at least a composite of the IT asset which comprise the enterprise's IT infrastructure. These assets, from a company perspective, include the process, document, rules, human resources, and service. A service is a collection of IT resources that it provides the customer to enable them to operate their business on a day-to-day and long-term basis. The stakeholder of the enterprise or the ultimate user of the asset are the represented separate. Enterprises and assets and stakeholder. As I stated earlier, our intent is to progress from an asset management approach toward a service-centric representation of the infrastructure to align the model more explicitly with service representation. We can regroup the main entities so that the model reflects the enterprise as a transaction between two roles: a provider and customer of the service being provided, and the service itself. In Figure 2, the model also explicitly identifies the provider and customers as a type of roles, rather as role and service are subset of an enterprise. So, enterprise, roles, provider, and customer, and service, professional service, and technical service. Figure 2, Model B. Now, the model can be used to present an exchange of service between generic provider and consumer companies or IT business enterprises. The service technical asset can reside with the provider or customer company. Particularly in larger organizations, some services are provided internally company-owned technical assets, while others are outsourced provides own technical assets. The model in Figure 3 illustrates a service that is provided by the company-owned IT department and subscribed to the internal lines of business. Company, role, provider, consumer, provider by, subscriber by, service, professional service, technical service, subscribers, and providers. This is the figure 3 model C. So, configuration items, there have company, rule, service, figure 4 model D. Logical, physical, and virtual. Note that up of this point, all the CIS discussed have been logical groupings of physical entities. These logical CLS represent grouping of CLS with similar properties, which exhibit common behavior and have common relationship to other CIS. For example, software is a logical CI. There are specific business application which version, release, and patch number, etc. is a physical CI for entities which provide the same function as a physical CIS but do not have a physical form. We define them as a virtual CIS. Example of virtual CIS are virtual machine in a server cluster environment. CI attributes. The characteristic or properties used to describe a CI are called its attributes. Every PC can be described by its serial number, asset tags, CPU, or memory size. Every person in a functional role has a name, title, login, ID, or a contact telephone number. Every service record has a number or detail to describe an event. An attribute is the abstract of properties. The attribute is the name, then the property itself may be John, Ellen, or Thomas. The distinction between CI and an attributes may depend on the level of detail with which an organization will track entities. A monitor may be considered attributes for a PC if the two are tracked as an ensemble, or it may be separate CI that is related or related to a PC. CI relationship. As depicted in figure 4, in addition to the attributes, CIS also have relationship with each other. This relationship provides valuable information about how CILs are grouped, the hierarchical relationship, and how they can influence each other, functional relationship. By tracing the relationship from one CI to the next, we can gain an understanding in how an action taken in a given CI, addition, removal, or modification, may influence the rest of the infrastructure and the organization.